Hey, I'm gonna try to make a quick review of the Alice in Wonderland movie and some mind control programming that I found within it and some Illuminati symbolism within that movie. It's Walt Disney, of course. So, just give me a minute. I'm just gonna pull out a couple things. I'm gonna try not to play too much of the movie. I don't wanna get in trouble for copyrights and everything else, so just take a look here. Where people walk upside down. That's silly. And there you see the Illuminati floor with the black and white checkered floor. This scene shows Alice going to a stranger's house.
Marianne!
Marianne!
She's calling her Marianne. Possibly a multiple personality.
What are you doing out here?
Marianne!
Don't just do something standing! No, no! Go, go! Go get my gloves! I'm late!
But late for what? That's just what I...
My gloves!
So she goes ahead in the stranger's house.
I suppose I'll be taking orders from Diamond next.
She goes ahead upstairs in the stranger's house.
Now, let me see.
A lot of sexual innuendo coming up here.
Oh.
Eat me.
Don't mind if I do.
This part coming up here where she grows through the house. I'm gonna pause so that we can look at the placement of Alice's legs through the house and see what's in the center here. See if I can back up one more step there. Oh, right there. Help, monster. And you see the placement of Alice's legs and what's in the center there, the window, right in between her legs. Monster is a code word. I'm thinking they're calling her monster to make her feel bad about herself, like she's not human. And then they're going to go through with some sexual innuendo here, some sexual abuse and trauma, maybe some language in here that may be used on children who are abused. What's his solution?
Pull it out the chimney.
Pull it out the chimney. Chimney would be a code word for a body part, I'm pretty sure.
A lizard with a ladder.
A lizard with a ladder.
Bill, Bill. We need a lantern with a little. Can you help us?
Fetch your service, Governor.
Tell me, lad, have you ever been down a chimney?
Why, Governor?
I've been down more chimneys, and then he cuts him off. Pull the monster out. Put your tail right down that chimney, he said. Okay, so it's getting all smoky. There's the release.
Well, there goes Bill.
There goes Bill.
Poor Bill.
Perhaps we should try a more energetic remedy.
Yes, anything, but hurry.
I propose that we,
Yes, go on, yes.
I propose that we, do... Fight! some kidding, just a stick or two. Hours, bit of rubbish ought to do.
Oh, dear.
We'll smoke the biner out. We'll smoke the monster out.
Smoke the monster out.
Not my beautiful bird out.
Oh, we'll roast the blighter.
Roast her toes.
We'll toast the bounder's nose.
Toast
not
her nose.
We'll make it clear that monsters aren't welcome.
Monsters aren't welcome.
Thank God.
Monster is the trigger word here. Smoke the monster out.
No, no, my poor house and furniture.
Dear, this is serious. I think it must.
He's more worried about his house and his furniture. And she eats the carrot. She puts that carrot right in her mouth. Don't eat me, he said.
I'm late. Oh, dear, I'm here. I shouldn't be there. I'm late. I'm late.
I say, do you have a
bet? Oh, must go. Goodbye. Hello. I'm late.
Wait. Please wait.
Young lady, do you have a bet?
No, I'm sorry, but Mr. Rabbit.
And then she goes on to the garden. Bread and butterflies, a little monarch butterfly programming there.
Who do you suppose?
Horsefly. A rocking horsefly.
And we sing, too.
You do?
Oh, yes. Would you like to hear Tell It to the Tulip?
No, let's sing about us.
We know one about the shy little violet.
Oh, no, not that old thing.
Shy little violets. They're the kids.
We shall sing Golden Afternoon. That's about all of us. Sound your A, Lily.
Notice there's a separation between the elites and the common people coming up here. Monarch butterfly programming. Dizzy daffodils, people who are asleep, the programmed. Tiger lilies love the dandelions. Okay. The weeds. The wheat and the tare. The wheat and the tares in the Bible. Dandelions are weeds. She was yawning. She's getting tired. She's gonna go to sleep. Mentally. And then there's a spider web wrapped around that. There they go with pulling her dress up. You can learn a lot of things from the flowers. And they start to talk about species and interbreeding coming up here. Family.
Do you suppose she's a wildflower?
They're trying to figure out her species.
I'm not a wildflower.
Just what species, or shall we say genus, are you, my dear?
Well, I suppose you call me a genus, humanus. Alice!
Ever see an Alice with a blossom like that?
Come to think of it, did you ever see an Alice?
Yes. Alice,
did you notice our petals? What a peculiar color.
And no fragrance.
Lifting up the dress again.
Rather scrawny, I'd say.
I think she's pretty.
Quiet, bud.
I'm not a flower.
Quieting the child.
Just what I suspected.
Common mobile vulgaris.
Common
person.
To put it bluntly, a weed.
Weed.
I'm not a weed.
Well,
look in the Bible for tares and wheat.
Well, good girl, let her stay here, goat seed.
Go on,
talking about her seed.
We don't want weeds in our
bed. No weeds in our bed.
If I were my right size, I could pick every one of you if I wanted to. And I guess that'll teach you.
Oh, she's all wet.
A lot of things from the flowers.
Seems to me they could learn a few things about manners.
And then it goes on to the caterpillar scene, which we won't even get into. And that was the 2004 release of Alice in Wonderland. And I hope you saw where she went in the house, the sexual innuendo, and also when she went into the garden, there was a lot of talk about species and interbreeding within the flowers and the weeds of the dandelion, the common people. If you look in the Bible, you can research a lot in there about the wheat, and the tares, okay? Basically, that has a lot to do with interbreeding between the giants, the Nephilim, the Anunnaki, and it's a very interesting thing to research, and some people think it ties into the UFO extraterrestrial thing that they're, not disclosing to the public. That they may be another species or race of life form out there that have been interbreeding with other people, regular people. And if you look in Genesis, I think it's Genesis 6:4, about the giants, it actually says that the sons of God will come together with the daughters of men. Sons of gods, and that reference to sons of gods does not mean the good God. Okay, these are evil gods. Okay, so that is something that you want to look into. And when these big companies like Disney and everything, it seems like they are subliminally referencing these things. To try to get it in the children's minds in a way that they are not going to understand, but think that somehow program it into our minds that it is a good thing, that it's okay, that it's something that you would want. Because pretty much they were like shunning Alice in the end there, saying that they don't want her in their bed. So, it was just really creepy. All right, thanks for watching.